Hello everyone, and welcome to another tutorial of AppV5 server install. I'm just going to install AppV5 beta 2. If you have seen my old tutorials in beta 1, there has been some additional features being added to the beta 2. I'm not going to go through all the necessary details or the installation for the necessary components such as .NET framework, but there are some additional requirements for AppV5 server beta 2. I have two servers here, the SQL server and the AppV server. The brown desktop here is the SQL server, and the blue desktop here is the AppV server. I have SQL 2012 installed on this SQL server, and let's just start installing the databases. So you can download the AppV server setup through Microsoft Connect and try it out for yourself. This is the beta 2, as you can see here. We accept the license terms. The new feature is basically the reporting server. You can see the reporting server and reporting server DB, which is additional database which will be installed on the SQL. So this is the SQL server, so I'm just going to install the management server database and the reporting server database. This is a default location here. Just going to have the default instance name and the default configuration, which will be the AppV management name of the database. And then it's the computer. It's a domain name and the AppV SRV01, which is the AppV server, which will have access to the management database. And the user that has the rights to create the database. Domain name, and in this instance I'm just going to use the administrator. Now this is the reporting database. It's basically the same. Use the default instance and use the default configuration, which is the AppV reporting database. Same here. I'm just going to set the same server. So this is going to be both the management server, publishing server, and the reporting server. I'll set the domain name and the server name. And this is the user that has access to create the database. Domain name and the administrator. Let's just install and wait a moment until it finishes. Okay, it has finished, so we can check the SQL Management Studio to check if the database has been created and if the server has the necessary rights. Okay. Connect here. So we have the AppV management database here, and the AppV server machine has been added. As you can see, it has a dollar sign here, and the AppV reporting database, same here. So everything is created on the SQL server. So let's go to the AppV server and install the AppV server. So the additional requirements for the beta 2 is the Visual C++ 2010, the 64-bit here, and also the Windows Management Framework 3. This is only a release candidate, so you can download it from Microsoft website. And for Windows 2008 R2 64-bit, you will need to choose this one. That's KB2506143. So I've already downloaded it here, so I'm just going to install it. The VMF3 requires a restart, so I'm just going to install that too here. It's pretty quick there. And this one, accept. I'm just going to finish the install, restart the computer, and I'll get back to you. So I've restarted the computer here and installed the necessary components. So I'm just going to start the AppV install. So it's basically just install. Accept the license terms. Now I'm just going to use click on the choose the management server, the publishing server, and the reporting server. Not the database, because I've already created them. The default location here. So the SQL server. SQL server name and the domain name. Use the default instance, and the SQL database name is AppV management. Same for the reporting server. Server name and the domain name. SQL default instance, and the database name is AppV reporting. Now I have a group in Active Directory named AppV admins. So I type in the domain name and the group name. This is the group that will have access to the management console. I'm just going to put port 81 here for the management server website configuration. I have to put the management server here. In the old beta 1, you had to use localhost and port 81. For the management server, but they have fixed it, so I can use the AppV SRV dot AppV dot local the sorry 01 AppV server. This is server name and the domain name. So they have fixed it in this beta 2. I'm just going to put port 82, and of course for reporting server I'm just going to use 83. Click on next and install. Just going to pause here for a moment while it installs. So the install has finished here. You can just click on close and go to application virtualization management console, and of course we need Silverlight for it to work. And you see, can see that it's basically very similar to the old one, sorry, the beta one. Can't seem to find any server here, don't know why. I have two packages here, Firefox and Office. I'm just going to share the directory here. Click on OK. Okay. And add these two packages. Firefox, add, and also Office 2010. So it's basically very similar to the beta one. So we have published these two applications here very quickly. So this is basically it. Thank you for watching. Hopefully I will see you soon. Bye bye.